Hartwell is a spectacular person.
And she's just so tenacious, and she just keeps going.
She is a very happy person, dynamic person.
They say, dynamite comes in small packages. That is Lori. She is a dynamo.
Passion for life, big heart.
This woman has been put on this planet for a special purpose, no doubt in my mind.
Lori Hartwell has made a difference in thousands of lives of people with chronic kidney disease. She is the model of living a fulfilling life despite her kidneys failing.
I was diagnosed with chronic kidney disease back in 1968 when I was 2 years old. And chronic kidney disease is when the kidneys have been impacted, something's happened to them, and basically they've been compromised. And either you seek treatment and you help prevent the further deterioration of the kidneys, or you're going to need dialysis or a transplant to survive.
I met Lori when she was about 7. I was a nurse at Children's Hospital in Los Angeles. Lori was a most self-directed little girl. She really knew what she wanted. She knew her treatment. She knew her medicines. She was in control in those days.
Well, back in 1968, kidney disease was in the pioneering stages. And luckily, I fell on the doorstep of a Dr. Richard Fine at Children's Hospital at Los Angeles that allowed me to be here because he was brilliant. He was a pioneer. He took risks, and he took risks with me that paid off. And I remember one time when I was 16 years old, and Dr. Fine said to me, Lori, someday you're going to write a book called I Can. I just know you're going to do it. And I think it was the first time I really had somebody say that they thought I would become something and I would accomplish something. And I would hold on to that little phrase in times and just felt so, so loved and cared about that he thought I would be something, a major physician in the country. I had a transplant when I was 13 that didn't work. I had one at 17 that didn't work. And I was told I would never get a transplant. Might as well make the most of the time I have left. And so I just started to enjoy life. I went and worked at a flower shop, and I moved into a version of a Melrose place and just decided to live my life. Well, when I was working at the flower shop, I would go next door and we would get lunch, and there was this group of gentlemen there that I would always chit-chat with, and there was a man named Eric Ward, and he was really intrigued by my knowledge and my persistence and just my overcoming of adversity. So Eric Ward said, well, why don't you come work for me?
We were dealing with very intense, difficult, crazy clients. And Lori had to learn very quickly how to interface with, these are people who are, very intelligent. They're making big purchasing decisions in the world of display advertising.
And for 4 years, he taught me so much about business, so much about creativity, and, really gave me the wisdom and the strength and the encouragement that I could do the same.
Lori was camping in the mountains above Los Angeles when she got a call for a perfect matched kidney. She never gave up hope. This gift of life inspired her to want to help her peers who were traveling the same road and searching for answers. 1993, Lori started the Renal Support Network. The goal is to instill health, happiness, and hope into the lives of people and family members who are coping with kidney disease.
I was sitting at the intersection of La Cienega and Sunset Boulevard at the stoplight, and it came to me, what do patients need? And it was really in big, bold letters right in front of me, the word hope. And I wanted to help provide hope to other people who have kidney disease. And that, in 1993, that's when I decided to start the Renal Support Network based on a statement, an illness is too demanding when you don't have hope. And I was gonna supply it, by golly.
And now now people look at the organization like it's a given that something like that exists. She is the one who identified that vacuum of in need for support. And so grassroots, and now it's become this major force in the renal community. And I'm not surprised by any of this.
I'm watching her go about her day-to-day activities of helping people with kidney disease. It's amazing, and it really is humbling. And she sets the bar very high for those of us who like to think of ourselves as do-gooders.
And RSN just helps so many people, and it's just such an amazing organization.
I'm so proud of Lori, that how she has risen above any sense of feeling like a victim of life. You never get that from Lori. You just don't. But where she might have come close was this idea that nobody would ever marry her, that she didn't feel attracted enough to attract the kind of person she could fall in love with.
I met my husband at Toastmasters, and you know, we were married a couple years later, and that's all in the past. And it's really amazing because Toastmasters gave me the ability to be able to be myself and let other people accept me for who I am.
And Lori accomplished what Dr. Fine predicted years before by writing a book about her experience as a patient and survivor.
Well, you know, Chronically Happy has sold over 15,000 copies and constantly getting requests. And I'm in the process of updating it and kind of telling, you know, my next stage.
Trying to find answers to your problems is worth the trouble. And having a good attitude while you do that is really worth the trouble.
I learned how to cope with issues and to just be a better person and follow some of her guidelines, and it worked. It really did.
Her book, Chronically Happy, really helped to put RSN on the map, and it gave Lori the opportunity to provide more programs for the Renal Support Network.
Some of the programs RSN offers is we have a prom every year for all the teenagers with kidney disease. I do a podcast called Kidney Talk. We publish a newsletter that goes nationwide called Live and Give, and it's there to inspire patients that they don't have to do this alone and gives them some tips to navigate their health. And then we have an 800 toll-free number where patients can call and talk to other patients, because after all, my mission is to be a network and let people know that they're not alone and that there's hope.
My favorite event is the prom. They bring together a couple hundred kids that all have different levels of kidney situations. They might be pre-transplant, on dialysis, beginning dialysis. And you see these kids and they're just dancing and having fun.
Tonight we have an incredible evening planned for them. They come in, they get their glamour photo taken, they can have their makeup and hair done if they like. We have music going on, and it's just an evening of fun and celebration.
Everyone looks wonderful, everyone's having a great time, everyone's dancing. The dresses are amazing, the gentlemen look debonair, and everyone's having a fabulous time, as they should.
Lori's luck finally ran out after her third kidney transplant puttered out after 20 years. Again, she was faced with the daunting task of dialysis and hoping another kidney would come her way. Her fourth kidney transplant.
And I had to go back on dialysis. I started, I did home hemodialysis, and then luckily I got a transplant in 2011 from my stepsister, who gave me the gift of life.
Today, a feisty Lori continues to branch out to help grow the network she created. She guests on both radio and TV talk shows nationwide. She advocates on federal and state level. Lori has received numerous awards in her recognition of her leadership and is a sought-after motivational speaker.
If there was one word that I would use to describe Lori, it would be amazing.
It's creative.
Intelligent dynamo.
It's wonderful.
Prankster.
Compassionate.
You have to work to be hopeful. It doesn't come to you. Like, some people are great at going to the gym every day. I'm not one of those people. But I do know how to maintain hope. And one of the reasons is by seeing other people be happy by your work. That in itself makes you hopeful that you're valuable and you have something to offer to society.